Hi, Stefan here. So today I just want to show you how we at DreamData can help you connect your B2B ad spend to the pipeline and the revenue that it produces. The reason why I want to do it today is that this week we put out these benchmarks showing how B2B companies are actually shutting down Facebook ads and LinkedIn ads and perhaps putting the more money into the safe harbor of the Google search ads, where they can at least select the keyword that gets clicked on. And that's all great. That might be a good strategy, it might not. But I want to firstly explain you a little bit about the challenges of putting the ad spend in of Google, inside of Google search ads when you're a B2B company. And then I'm going to show you how that kind of is resolved with DreamData. So one, the challenges with B2B companies and ads in general is that B2B companies are purchasing stuff as a team. There's two, three, four, five people involved in the deal. It's going to take 6 to 12 months before from the first click to the revenue comes along. There's multiple sessions, multiple devices, etc. And this is a problem for you as a B2B marketer, because typically the money you spend on the ads is maybe the first touch, or at least spend on the first part of the journey, and maybe on one single person and one single device. And the problem is that B2Bs are buying as a team, so if there's three people involved, you might start the journey with cost on one person, and then it's a third person who comes in and signs the contract. And this means that you cannot connect the spend, the cost you had on starting the journey, with the revenue that is produced. So what DreamData does for you is that it builds an account-based timeline where it says there's such a thing as an account, and every person that belongs to this account, we're going to take those touches and map into one journey. So this enables you now to, instead of having two separate journeys, to put them into the same journey. So if the first click on this account was a Google search ad, we can join that together with what did you actually win in the CRM system when you had that closed one account. And this enables you to actually compare the cost and the revenue that you produced. And to me, that's the only meaningful way to judge whether your ad spend is working or not. But still, it's not as simple as that, because you also need to know how long does an average journey inside from paid ads actually take to become, let's say, a sales qualified lead, before you can actually make decisions upon what's working and what's not working. So I've pulled this one up inside of DreamData. It's called revenue segmentation by first touch channel. What you'll be able to see here is that different channels takes different time. It represents an average deal value that is different. There's different amount of people involved in it and so forth. But for like optimizing our ads on Google search ads, I'm particularly interested in how long should it take from like a click on the ad until the ad actually, if you think about it, it's kind of a seed that you plant when you purchase the click, but then it needs to prosper. And then in average, that takes an average of 31 days before it hits the sales qualified pipeline. Okay, now I know that it takes, let's say a month from the first touch until they buy. With this information, I can now go head over to my Google search ads and do some quality analysis here. So given that it's end of June, let's say that we'll cap the timeline by May, and then we'll say, okay, how much money have we spent this year on Google search ads? So what you see here on the top bucket here is the stuff you get from Google Ads, which is your cost, the impressions, and amount of clicks. That's great, but it's not very useful for explaining whether you actually have made a good deal with these ads or not. So this is what DreamData gets you. Our tracking script records how many visitors actually arrived on your website, how many contacts you converted from these visitors, and how many companies does this represent. And then we help you join this together in our data model with the actual pipeline value, the actual money that you've produced with these ads. So those 45,000 actually produced 100 touched 134 deals. Given the attribution model you select, whether that's first touch or our data-driven model that we typically recommend, then you can see that out of the money you spend, you produce 98 deals. And those deals actually represent a pipeline value of $210,000. So given that we spent 45,000 and we produced 210, that looks maybe like a good idea. But let's not buy that as the truth initially, because when you browse down here, you can see brand is very represented. And what we have for you here is really the magic, you can say. On the left side, you see the stuff that Google Ads will give you. You get the cost, the clicks, the impression, the cost per click, etc. In reality, these are vanity numbers because you don't have the revenue component that you can compare with. And then you can't make decisions based on what's driving revenue or not. So this is what DreamData enables you to do. We glue together the revenue component for B2B companies so you can see how many leads, how much revenue, what's the cost per acquisition given the ad spend that you have. And if you and your team have agreed upon what can you pay per acquisition for a given pipeline stage, you just browse your eyes here. Let's say we've agreed that it's 500 euros we can spend per deal. Then we can see that these campaigns are actually a lot above the average that we want to be paying. So either we have to stop them, or we at least need to try to optimize them. Are we showing, the search queries, are they a little bit off to compare to the keyword that we wanted to go for? And the ones down here that are below the target cost per acquisition, well, they are very good candidates for spending more money. So as I look here, I can see here we're only buying 27% of the traffic. Here we're only buying 40% of the traffic available. So these represents real opportunities to spend money on Google search ads and then expecting that to correlate with producing more pipeline, producing more revenue. And that is the only meaningful way you run Google ads. It is look at the cost, but also run an account-based data model so you can see whether it actually produces revenue or not. If not, you're risking just throwing money out of the window. So have you started Google search ads in your B2B company? Then try out DreamData and I think you'll be very excited from what you see. Nice. Have a good day. Bye.